said, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him, man, because he is so worthy to be praised. Amen. The Bible says, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, it is his name that is to be praised. See, I don't know what you come to do, but I come to praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
We know that Jesus is the reason for the season, but he's the reason for every season. Amen.
Amen.
Right now, we're going to get started by the voices of worship. Say amen for the voices of worship.
Amen.
Somebody
wake up this morning.
That's right.
And I thank God that God is a good God.
Yes. Amen. 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 I must, my kidnapping skills must not be working right. That's my aunt right there, and I missed you so, amen. It's so good to see you this morning.
Amen.
Is there somebody else in the house that wants to testify this morning? Come on now.
I'd like to honor God this morning.
Amen. Is there anybody else who'd like to testify? Come on. Yes, sir.
I just want to say I'm thankful for my family because we're going to all be going to my grandma's Christmas, and my grandma's like 70 something. So I'm just thankful that she's still here with us today.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Anybody else? Start with the announcements. I do want to make sure on our prayer list, amen, that we acknowledge these names, Sister Christine Jennings, Sister David Boyd, Sister Gladys Baker, Sister Denise Humphreys, Reverend Nathaniel Wilson Jr., Brother Curtis Lowell, Brother Aaron Bryant, Sister Jackie Griffin, Brother and Sister Winfrey Easterly, and if I'm not mistaken, Miss Sister Margaret Ellison has passed, so we're praying for that, her family, that their time of bereavement. Brother Darrell Elliott, I'm sorry. Brother Bill Harrington, Miss Pat Merrill, amen. Miss Pat, y'all the one saying God is, amen. We're praying for her this morning. Deacon Oxendine is not with us. He's not feeling well this morning. We're going to pray and lift him up. Brother Carl Mills, Brother David Ayers, the Bibiaco family, Sister Freddie Kate Johnson, Sister Arlene Peck, Brother Michael Brown, Sister Ethel Hall, Brother Charlie Morgan, Sister Hazel Marie Pratt, all of our local and state officials, all of those that we're duty bound to pray for, and the leaders of our nation. So we want to lift all of those names up in prayer, amen, as we get started. So let the church say amen as we go on with our announcement.
Gifts and everything, because we're not going to interrupt church Sunday.
Sunday morning. So bring your cards, gifts, whatever you want to give. Please bring it on the 23rd. Please bring it then.
It looks like a game.
It is a game, okay. And it's the songs of Christmas. So if you want to get one and challenge your mind to the Christmas songs that you know, feel free to get one at the church, and I'll have an answer key for you next Sunday. Or Saturday, I'll have an answer key for you Saturday.
I A song high above the tree with a voice as big.
time.
Amen.
If you know it was the Lord who brought you here this morning, we will be able to say amen just one more time.
Amen.
First, give an honor to God who is the head of my life, to my Lord and Savior Jesus, being in Christ, to the precious and infallible power of the Holy Ghost. To each and every one of you under the sound of my voice, I greet you with Jesus' joy. This is the day that the Lord has made. I don't know what distractions are going on in life, but we will rejoice.
Amen.
And be glad in it. Amen.
Amen.
I dare wanted to preach, amen, from that glorious Sunday last week backwards to the birth of Christ. But I realize and recognize that this time of the year can be heavy for people. So I prayed to the Lord, and the Lord directed me to 1 Samuel chapter 17. Very familiar passage of scripture. Very familiar passage of scripture. You may be seated this morning as I read, but I want you to turn to 1 Samuel chapter 17. 1 Samuel chapter 17, go down to verse 38. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
If you don't have it, say wait. Amen. I hear you. 1 Samuel chapter 17, I'm reading from the King Standard Version this morning. Verse 38. Let's get your pages turned, so I'll wait for you, man. It's all right. Everyone has it, say amen.
Amen.
Bible says, then Saul clothed David with his armor. He put a helmet of bronze on his head and clothed him with a coat of mail. And David strapped his sword over his armor, and he tried in vain to go, for he had not tested them. Then David said to Saul, I cannot go with these, for I have not tested them. So David put them off. Then he took his staff in his hand and chose five smooth stones from the brook and put them in his hand in the shepherd's, and put them in his shepherd's pouch. His sling was in his hand, and he approached the Philistine. And the Philistine moved forward and came near to David with his shield bearer in front of him. And when the Philistines looked and saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth, ruddy and handsome in appearance. And the Philistines said to David, am I a dog that you come to me with sticks? And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. Then the Philistine said to David, come to me, and I will give your flesh to the birds of the air and to the beasts of the field. Listen, church. Then David said to the Philistine, you come to me with a sword and with a spear and with a javelin. But I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. I want to talk to somebody this morning and let somebody know in here that giants do fall.
Amen.
Let us bow our head. Heavenly Father, we come to you right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I cannot teach, cannot preach, say the unction of the Holy Ghost be. Father, I'm asking that you move me out of the way right now and hide me behind that old rugged cross, that it is your glory that is to be revealed. Father, bless this congregation. Give them ears to hear, a heart to receive. And if there's one that don't know your son, bring them, saying, I yield, I yield. What must I do to be saved? Father, would you raise your hedge of protection up around this house, not let Satan in. Save the Lord, rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Now be my guide and strength and hold me in your hands. In Jesus' name we pray, and let the saints of God say amen.
Amen. Amen.
War strategist Sun Tzu says it like this: in order to battle in a war, you must first know your enemy. No one right now in life, that many of us have enemies, amen. And what our enemy does is our enemy studies us very well. Our enemy realizes and sits back and watches us and sees what our tendencies are. Our enemy also knows the things and the stumbling blocks that he can put in our way to make us fall down and take our eyes and focus off what we're trying to get done. Also, our enemy knows and studies who our allies are. In other words, who can help us when we're in the battle. I don't know about you, amen, but whether you know it or not, there is a war going on. Oh, I know, amen, we're trying to get to Christmas time and we're trying to celebrate the goodness of Jesus and have a good time with our family. But sometimes in our life, this can also be a tough season.
Yes.
You don't have to say amen this morning. You can just realize and flash back over your mind a little bit and realize that there's a war going on down on the inside. It's something right now trying to keep you distracted and keep you from praising your God. Amen. The enemy realizes and recognizes what your stumbling blocks are. Do you never realize that when the enemy comes at you, he never comes at you with something that you don't like, but he always wants to tempt you with something that you do like. Y'all right what I'm saying? You know your enemy, amen, when it is a situation where somebody can get on your nerves, it always seems like that one individual never leaves your life. Am I right about it? You know, amen, when there's a certain circumstance at the job, amen, that you wouldn't wish to go away and just move somehow out of your life, amen. But it just seems like it just keeps hanging on to you. There may be an addiction in your life. There may be something in your life that you're trying to shake off, but every time you try to shake it, just seems like it sticks to you. It's hard to praise God when you're bound down and when something has you distracted and you don't realize where the Lord has brought you from. I need somebody to help me this morning to understand, amen, my life is not over yet, amen, because I know that the Lord woke me up this morning and he gave me one more time to praise him. What do you have to praise him for? I have to praise him for he brought me a mighty long way, amen. I have to praise him for the food he put on my table. I have to praise him for the clothes that are on my back. I have to praise him this morning because when I was about to lose my mind, he regulated my mind for it. I don't know about you, but there's a whole lot of things we need to be praising God for, amen. Sometimes we sit in the house of God and act like we're just supposed to be here, or we're doing God a privilege because we come to church this morning. I need two or three of you to understand, God didn't have to allow you to get here this morning. He could have stopped you somewhere along the way. God didn't have to hold you in your right mind, amen. God did not even have to put food on your table, but somehow he blessed us anyhow. And I don't know about you, no matter how I feel, no matter what I'm going through, I can always lift my hands in the sanctuary and tell somebody that my God has been with me. I don't know what you come to do this morning. You can come and sulk if you want to. You can come and think about how the enemy's trying to attack you if you want to. But I come to praise the Lord.
Come on.
I come to lift him up, amen. Even when the enemy's trying to destroy me, I know who the lifter of my head is, amen. Even when he tries to hold me down, I know how to shake the devil off because God has been good to me.
Yes, he has.
The enemy knows your ally. You know how they do, amen. They want to see who's on your team. Y'all know somebody been in a battle here before, amen. Somebody been in a fight in the street. Somebody knows, amen, and you start sizing up the other team. You're not worried about the one standing in front of you all the time, but you're worried about they got some backup. Am I right about it?
Come on.
But understand this right now. See, the enemy is attacking you because he knows who your ally is. The enemy is attacking you, amen, because he knows that you're a child of the Most High God. He knows, amen, that you have been fearfully and wonderfully made. He knows no matter what the world is trying to do to you, man, he has made you the head and not the tail. He realizes and understands that doors have been opened for you that no man can shut. Somehow, some way, God has took care of you, amen. I need somebody to help me this morning and say, alcohol didn't destroy me, amen. Drugs couldn't hold me back, amen. Living a wayward life didn't stop me, but somehow, some way, God still made a way out of nowhere. He didn't do it for anybody.
Yeah.
See, the enemy wants to destroy us. And what the enemy does is he makes himself bigger than he really is.
Mm-hmm.
He amplifies himself in our lives so we can take our distractions instead of giving them to the Lord and focus on the enemy. What we do is we size that enemy up ourselves and we realize and recognize some of those enemies be small in our life. And those small enemies we don't worry about so much because what we do, we figure we can fight our own battle and we don't need the help of the Lord. Oh, but when the battle looks like it's a big old giant coming our way, and when it looks like it's a mountain coming our way, then we want to call on the Lord.
Yes.
See, we have to understand something, amen. We should call on the Lord no matter what the size of the enemy is. No matter what the circumstances that are going on in our life. We should call on the Lord anyhow, amen. When the Lord woke you up this morning, you said, Lord, help me to walk worthy of the calling.
Yes.
Lord, when the Lord woke you up this morning, you ought to say, Lord, will you turn me from my wicked ways? Lord, will you deliver me from evil and temptation? Help me, Father, when I get to the house in the morning, praise your holy name because you've been good to me. Lord, I can remember it was a time when I had nothing to eat, but somehow, some way, you put food on my table. I can remember, Father, when people would turn their back on me, but you stuck to me closer than any brother that I ever had. I can remember when I would cry my eyes and go cry myself to sleep at night, amen, but somehow, some way, God lifted my head and made a way out of no way. When the enemy came against me, amen, you raised up a standard like a flood. When those folks said it wasn't going to be anything, somehow, you propped me up anyhow.
Yes.
I don't know what you've come to do, brothers and sisters, and I come to look and reflect on where the Lord has brought me from.
Yes,
amen.
Yes. Amen.
This war that's going on in our lives is something like the battle that was going on in so-called in 1 Samuel chapter 17. For it was a situation over there on one side of the hill, amen, there was a group called the Philistines. Mm-hmm. And these Philistines, amen, were antagonizing the children of Israel. The children of Israel were down in the valley of Elah trying to figure out how they were going to mount up their battle to fight these Philistines. Because, you know, like I know, when somebody bullies you, sooner or later, what you're going to have to do in order to get rid of a bully is you're going to have to stand up and fight. Y'all right?
Yes,
what I'm saying?
Yes, right.
You can try to run from him. You can try to go a different way to school. You can try to do all you're big enough to do. But sooner or later, you're going to have to mount yourself up and fight that bully that is in your way. You don't realize it or not, but Satan is the biggest bully that you ever faced. Amen. That he wants to bully and attack you and keep you from doing what God wants you to do.
Yeah.
Sooner or later, you're going to have to realize you're going to have to fight him.
Right.
The Bible says now, as they were standing there, the Philistines had something on their side because everybody needs an ally. And their biggest ally for the Philistine army at that time was this 9'6" giant by the name of Goliath.
Yes.
And Goliath was big and he had about 200 pounds of armor that he was wearing on him at the time. And what he was doing for 40 days is he was walking to and fro and he was antagonizing the children of Israel. He was just daring. He said, all I need you to do out of that whole group of y'all, I just need one of y'all to come fight me. And if one of y'all beat me, then we'll be your slaves. But if I beat your man, y'all are going to be slaves to us. He was antagonizing them day after day for 40 days. Does that sound like any enemy you ever had, amen?
Oh,
when
yeah.
You praying to the Lord,
oh,
and you
yeah.
shake the devil
yeah.
off, it just seems like yeah. he jumps right back on you. You get up in the morning and you're feeling real good, like you're going to get yourself together, amen? You're ready for a new day, but somehow that same devil just keeps on fighting you. You get about Wednesday, man, and you're excited about how good God's been. It feels good at work. But that devil just chugs you one more time. Is there anybody beside me that just wish he'd leave me alone? Is there anybody beside me that realizes that every time I try to move, he's going everywhere I go? Sooner or later, you're going to have to stand still.
Yes.
All right,
well, yes.
The Bible says that this man, this 9'6" giant with 200 pounds of armor, was walking to and fro and was antagonizing God's people. Y'all don't hear me this morning.
Uh-huh.
See, the Philistines had built up and they were praising Goliath. You got to be careful because what you praise becomes your God.
All right.
Y'all ain't helping me even this morning. The Bible says that they were going about and they were excited because they had this big giant on their side. Man, you got to realize what the children of Israel, they were going through some changes themselves. You remember the children of Israel because they weren't excited about when Moses was taking care of them. They weren't excited when Joshua took over, amen. And when Joshua died, amen, they wanted judges. When they got tired of judges, they had to ask for a king. Did they not, amen? They said, Lord, we need a king. And what the Lord did, he was upset. Why do you need a king? Because I should be your king. Y'all don't hear that, do you?
Yeah.
See, what we looking for in today's world is we looking for a king, amen. Y'all think King James is, no, I'm not King James. I'm not talking about LeBron. I'm talking about my Father in
heaven.
See, he is our God. We understand those things. Because now what the Israelites had a problem with, the reason why they couldn't fight, you got to be careful, because who you praise will be your God. The Israelites, they thought more about Saul than they thought about anything. Mm-hmm. So they were following Saul instead of following God. Y'all know what I'm saying?
Yes.
See, many of us do the same thing. We follow our own little gods. Let's stay home on Sunday morning. God bless you with a brand new house. You stay home Sunday and clean it up.
Yeah.
God, give you a brand new car. You stay home Sunday and put some shine on it.
Come on.
Y'all don't hear me this morning.
Come on.
Every now and then, when God blesses us, all we want to do now is get some physical blessings. I need somebody to understand the physical blessings can come and go.
Yeah.
But my God lasts forever. Y'all know what I'm
saying?
Says that this giant was antagonizing him, Sister Lisa, walking to and fro, antagonizing him, looking big in front of them. And now what they were doing, they were trying to get themselves together to go fight this giant. But the thing about it was, is they were scared. Y'all right what I'm saying?
Right.
Anytime you have to do something for the Lord, won't fear come out first? Amen.
Yeah.
Anytime you ask the solo and you've been singing in the back of the choir, somebody asks you to sing, what's the first thing happen to you? You get scared, don't you?
Come on.
When somebody hears your testimony, say, boy, you look like a deacon, amen. Then you sign up to be a deacon, and all of a sudden they ask you to read a scripture out loud before a man. Now you're getting scared, amen. You just sit through Sunday school paying attention to your lessons and being good. Somebody said, you look like a preacher. What did you do? You got up there and got yourself to preaching and got scared. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying this morning. That fear is going to stop you in everything it is you do. No matter what you try, fear will be in your way. This giant had already scared Saul. Now, if Saul's scared, what do you think about the children of Israel?
Yes.
They were up there, one side the Philistines, the other side the Israelites. And as they were battling, amen, they realized that fear had taken over them. And they heard this command from this Philistine, this giant. He said, all I need is one of you to come across and fight me. And if you fight me and you win, then we'll be your slaves. But if I beat you, then you will be my slaves.
Well.
And Saul had begun to get scared.
Mm-hmm.
And what was happening at the time over in Bethlehem, Judah, was this little old ruddy little shepherd boy. And this little old shepherd boy was over there tending to his father's few little sheep.
Uh-huh.
And his father was so excited about his older brother, his older sons being in Saul's army, that he told his youngest son, you need to take them some cheese sandwiches.
Yeah.
While they're up there back. And when you get over there and you take them cheese sandwiches, what I need you to do is come back to me and give me a good report.
Yeah.
Let me know how my sons are doing in battle. And I need you to understand that when they go over there, pay close attention to see how the other team is fighting my sons. The Bible says that David, being obedient, the young son would go over and he would take his brothers these cheese sandwiches. And as this little old ruddy boy, this little old cute boy would go up there, and the enemy would undermine him because he was small, and his brothers would undermine him because he was the younger brother. And he would come and ask questions about the war that was going on. And his brothers would say things to him like this: what are you doing here? Won't you go back over there to dad's and feed them few little sheep that you have? You know how the world does. Is there anybody here ever been told that he felt small in life? Amen.
Come on.
Has anybody ever spoken down to you this morning? Amen. And you realize what it feels like, make you feel real small. But I need to tell somebody, and don't worry about that, amen, because help is on the way.
Yeah.
I need to tell somebody, amen, that you serve a God who's great being in the world.
Yes.
All right. But the Bible says, as they were fighting and back and forth deciding who was going to fight this enemy, amen, this big old giant, that David saw something. David saw something in the way that this giant was wanting to fight. See, you have to understand something. When you fight the enemy, you can't fight an enemy like he wants to fight.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all ain't going to help me.
All right, come on.
You can't fight that enemy, amen, on his terms.
All right.
You got to figure out what your best strategy and your best fighting skill is to fight with that.
Yes.
See, Goliath, man, he was an infantry style fighter. What he wanted to do is he wanted to go hand to hand in combat.
Right.
He had all of this big old shield and all his armor on. And what he wanted to do is he wanted to intimidate the one on the other side.
All right.
And what he would do, amen, is he would use his mouth to instill fear in you before you even got into the fight. Because if he can make himself look real big in the battle, amen, it will keep you small in the fight.
All right.
It will keep you from trying to do what you're called to do, amen. And it was also a cavalry type warrior, amen, who would ride in on chariots and horses. But I didn't see that the Israelites had any chariots or horses at this time. But there was also a projectile warrior. And what a projectile warrior would do was they would figure out if the enemy would be bigger than them, amen. They would figure out that they had to have something to fight this big enemy, to kill that big enemy.
All right.
They couldn't do it with their own strength, amen. They had to have a different strategy. So they had to have something that they would attack, maybe shoot something at him, or maybe just maybe have something that you could sling. And in those days and times, it was a sling that they would use.
All right.
And if you got skilled, amen, with that sling, you could take out anything that come nigh your dwelling. See, this little old boy realized something, because when he was over there in his father's field feeding them little bitty old sheep that he had, a few sheep that his brothers had, he said that one day that a lion came through. And when that lion came through to attack his father's sheep, amen, he said, what did I do? He said, well, I got my sling, amen. And I put that lion to flight. Y'all can hear what I'm saying right now. How many times in your life have you been in a battle that people don't know anything about, amen? Is there anybody under the sound of my voice said I fought all night long last night?
Yes.
I fought the enemy all night long. Somebody wanted to keep my head down. But when I walked through them doors, I had to say I'm going to praise my God. Is there anybody in here that you've been keeping your mouth quiet too long this morning? Anybody caught hell all week last week? Amen. But I thank God that you brought me here this morning. Somebody said we've been made and do for night.
Yes.
But joy came this morning when I got up. That joy picked me up out of the bed, amen. Therefore, that joy made a way out of no way. Brought me here and clothed in my right mind. And this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. Anybody know that the world can't take it away from me? You better start praising your God even right now. Praise Him for the victories that you're going to have in 2024, amen. Praise Him for the overcoming that you're going to do tomorrow, amen. Praise Him every time that enemy comes against you like a flood, amen. I don't know what you're going to do, but I'm going to praise my God. Because with me and Him together, we all enjoy. And if God be for you, what devil in hell can be against you? Is there anybody in here excited this morning about how somebody said I've been blind, but now I can see. Been wrong, but now I'm found. I'm so glad that I'm here in Jesus' name. When the devil had me down, it should have killed me. But when God reached down and picked me up, did He make a way out of no way? Ain't it good to anybody in Jesus' name? Ain't my God a good God? Y'all running down to church this morning. We trying to hold them down, but I can't stay down. I gotta tell somebody He's a good God. He's gonna keep my mouth shut, but I gotta tell somebody He's all right with me. He's all right with me.
Yeah. Come on.
Thank you, Jesus. David sang something. He sang something. He seen this giant walking around asking somebody, anybody, won't you come out from there? But I'm so glad,
so glad.
I don't think y'all heard me this morning. I said I'm so glad,
so glad.
When he was over there in his father's field, nobody could see what he was going on. Nobody seen the tears that he cried and the shame that he felt because they thought he was little, amen. Something about feeling little. I bet he had a little man syndrome. He said, well, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go over and I'm going to fight that giant for myself. So I don't want to fight him. I'll fight him my very own self. I don't know about you, but that's a good thing. But the Bible said, now Saul was so scared, he was supposed to be king.
Alright.
Now when the Cain mess up, when he's scared, we got a problem.
Yes.
The king was so scared, Saul was so scared. The Bible says that he all of a sudden started putting on his arm onto David. The Bible said that he had David bowed down with his stuff on. Y'all don't hear me. Saul said, I can't fight him. But you're willing to fight him. Go ahead. All right. But before you go, let me give you my stuff. Bible said he took Saul's big old stuff and put on that little old ruddy boy.
All right.
Put that stuff on him, amen. Put his coat of armor on him. Put his helmet on him.
All right.
Get his sword and his shield.
All right,
I don't think y'all hear what I'm saying.
Right.
See, he understands something.
All right.
That's some weight that he can't supposed to carry.
Right.
But he said, I'll go with him. He wanted to fight that devil so bad. I mean, that giant so bad, he wanted to fight him anyhow. He said, I'm going to go with your clothes on. But he realized after taking a couple of steps with the wrong war clothes on, he realized that he couldn't fight that fight. He said, I was going in vain, amen. He said, Saul, here goes your stuff back. Because it just don't fit me, amen. What are you saying to me, Pastor Jones? What I'm saying is, you can't fight a battle like somebody else. You better fight that battle in your own way. God only may only want you, amen. And you're glad he only did one time. What I'm trying to tell you is, better keep your hand in God's unchangeable hand. Am I right about it? Now the Bible says, what I'm going to do, amen. Said King David, little old ruddy David at the time. He said he took that David back to Saul. He said, in the shepherd's bag. Did I ever tell you that the Lord is my shepherd? And I shall not want. Bible said he took five little smooth stones, amen, and put in his shepherd's bag. He had his sling in his right hand. And he said, I'm marching toward David's house. Now, the Goliath's house. He said, when the Philistine saw him, amen, the Philistine kept talking junk. He said, what do you think? You're bringing this little kid right here, and this is what I'm supposed to go up against. I don't understand. He said, who do you think I am, a dog or something? You brought some sticks, what are you going to fight me with them? King David listened to everything he said, amen. But I'm so glad that he had a quick mind and a quick tongue, amen. Because he said, did you hear what you came against me with? You came up here with your sword and your shield. You even had the spear and the javelin, amen. That's what you came to meet with. He said, but I come to you in one name, amen.
Yeah.
I come in the name of the Lord God that is here with me. I come in the name of the Lord who woke me up this morning and started me on my way. I came in the name of the Lord that put food on my table and clothes on my back.
Come on.
Giant, amen, because he thought it was big because he had a 200 pound piece of armor on. And he walked around in that 200 piece of pound armor.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody scared of him. But can I tell you that my Savior carried a 200 pound cross up the beach of that cross?
Yeah.
I don't think y'all heard what I'm saying. Somebody said they hung him high and stretched him wide. But I'm so glad. Yeah.
are here. Yeah.
Giants do fall.
Yes.
I don't think y'all heard me.
Yes.
Giants do fall.
Yes.
Giants do fall.
Yes.
Giants do fall.
Yes.
That giant of depression, it does fall.
Yeah.
That giant of addiction, it does fall.
Yeah.
But you got to trust in the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You're standing on your feet.
Thank you, Lord.
Why are you standing on your feet? I don't think it's strange that this time of year we get heavy.
Mm-hmm.
There's people we miss.
Yes.
There's things in our life that we reflect back on.
Yes.
There's spaces that are empty that were once there. And it wants to hold us down. That can be a giant in your life.
Yes.
But you got to fight back.
Yes, amen.
You got to say, giant, I'm still here.
Yeah,
all right. Giant, I'm still here.
Yeah,
come on.
Oh, you may have took my loved one. You may have took my mom. You may have took my daddy. You may have took my husband. You may have took my father, my mother. But I'm still here.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
And I got to praise you anyhow.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm just asking you this morning, while you're standing on your feet, if there's one under the sound of my voice that don't know Jesus for himself,
come on.
Come on down this morning. Come on down. If you want to join this church, you may come by letter, candidate for baptism, or Christian experience. But come. If you need prayer, let's pray this morning.
Yes.
Let's pray. Come on. Don't waste your time. Come on, let's pray.
Amen.
Let's take it to the Lord right now. There's heaviness, Lord, that I want you to lift off of me. There's a way that I should be living and I'm not living. I'm living beneath what you've called me to be, God. Come on, let's pray. Ain't nothing wrong with prayer. Listen, brothers and sisters, we all go through something.
Amen.
We all have an issue. We all have a circumstance. We all have our own battles.
Yes.
From the pulpit to the back door.
Thank you, Lord.
But I need one. I need one to come stand with me and say, Lord, for you I'm going to live and for you I'm going to die.
Come on.
I'm going to put my hand in your unchanging hand. Will that be enough? Come on, brothers and sisters. Come on. Amen.
Yes.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Right now, in the name
If you open up the door, Father God, make it feel right, oh God. In the name of Jesus. God, I'm praying for this church family right now, Father God. I'm praying that you continue to allow us to grow, Father God. Allow us not to look to the left or to the right, but look to the hills, Father God. From what's coming about here. God, I'm asking right now, please help these people. Right now, in the name of Jesus.
Right now.
Please move right now, Father God. Strengthen where we're weary, Father God. Comfort where we're weak, Father God. Give us guidance right now where we need. In the name of Jesus.
Mighty name.
We'll be careful, God.
Yes.
To give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 All right. doesn't matter what it is, the enemy will come against you in everything you try to do for the Lord. Young men, I'm so proud of you. Keep doing what you're doing, amen. Keep standing strong for the Lord. I see you brought another soldier with you, amen.
Yes.
Y'all looking good? What's up, partner? All right, man. All right. Good to see you this morning. Amen. Thank God for everybody. We know it's approaching that time where we're going to celebrate Jesus and we're going to take care of this baby. I do have to say, again, in our presence is always football royalty.
Yes.
This young man is our little patriot MVP. Am I saying that right? Come on, stand up.
Come on.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. We're so proud of you, man. It's all right when you get up like that. Just wave your hands and say, you're doing good, man. We're proud of you. Keep it up, right? We're going to celebrate you. We're going to celebrate our young people. We're going to celebrate when you make accomplishments. And guess what? When things don't go your way, we're still going to celebrate you and be with you in your hand.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Because the blood is bigger than the mud.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for each and every one of you. We love you. Amen. Keep smiling. Keep believing. And keep pressing on. Amen. Let us bow. Dear Father, we praise you. We magnify you. We glorify your name. For great is our faithfulness toward men. God, we just thank you for everybody under the sound of my voice. Father, you know this. In every situation, name by name, one by one. I'm just asking, Father God, that you would walk with them while they're on this tedious journey. And Father, as we leave this place with not your presence, please go with us, rest, rule, and abide in us. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the saints of God say amen.
Amen.
Don't forget to go downstairs and get your girl home. Sing it. Hello? Hey, by the way, don't forget, what time is the play? 6? 5 o'clock. Saturday, December 23rd, 5 o'clock. Play practice is Wednesday, Thursday.